Welcome to YouTube Ministries of Jesus. And I'm your friend, your brother, Xavier Askina in Jesus Christ. So today we are going to make another video, which is a topic on how to hear the voice of the Lord. And with me, we have Sister Lucy, who will be sharing her experiences on how did she hear the voice of God and how each one of you watching this video will be able to hear the voice of the Lord. We'll also pray at the end so that God may talk to each one of you and change your lives forever. So Sister Lucy, welcome to this episode. And first question which I would like to ask is, what was the first time that you heard the voice of the Lord, and how did you know that that was God who was talking to you?
Yeah. So actually, I was born as a Christian since my childhood, and I used to do my regular prayers and stuff, but I don't know, whenever I used to talk to my friends, and I was very curious as to, how they heard the voice of God, and they used to tell me that, they would see some verses going across their head, or, they would hear from, or, have a dream and stuff. So, I was always wondering, because I never heard the voice of God like the way people heard. So I used to be always worried, but there was a time when I had to travel out of India. I was in Guatemala for almost 6 months, and at that time I had a lot of alone time. So what I thought is, I put it to better use. I don't know the Bible that well, so I, spent time reading the Bible. But started off with praising and worshiping God, and at that point in time, when I was praising and worshiping God, I just had a question in my mind. That was the first time when I heard the voice. So the question was that, God, I don't know the Bible that well. So if I have to even talk to people about you, about the good things that you've done for us, about the good news, how do I go about doing it? And I just continued my praise and worship. And as usual, I have this habit of reading the Bible verse chapter by chapter. So I finished Acts chapter 17, and I moved on to Acts chapter 18. And in that, I found a verse in Acts chapter 18, verse 25, where it says that Apollos spoke very, boldly, though he only knew the baptism of John. So I was wondering that if he only knows the baptism of John and he preached that boldly, even if I know just one thing, and which we all know, John 3:16, that Jesus Christ died for our sins and is risen again, and whoever believes in him will be saved. So if I just know one bit, I can just preach the word of God. So this was my first experience, and I undoubtedly, I know that it is from God, because it's from the Bible, it's from the scripture.
That's how God speaks to each one of us, through scriptures. Yes, that was the first experience that you had, that you came to know that God is speaking to you.
Yes, I was so thrilled.
Yes, yes, of course. This is what each of the Christian or anybody who wants to talk to God, this is one way where God talks to them, through scriptures. That was also my similar experience which I had. It was little different, that is, I wanted to be a missionary. I wanted to preach, follow God. But I wanted to make sure, if I am following God, I should listen to God's, hear to God's words. So one day, in my prayer, I was praying and I asked the Lord, if I have to follow you, you speak to me. And just a few minutes before that, my friend had visited me, and he had actually made a mockery of me, telling me, now you want to be a missionary, And I could not tell him anything, reply to him anything back. So what I did, I went to my prayer, I sat there, and I asked God in my prayer, God, if I want to be your follower, I should be knowing that I am listening to your voice and doing. So I closed my eyes, I was in prayer, and in that silence time, I heard a voice talking to me from within. And it said, tell your friend that visa, what he is waiting for, will come to him in next 2 months and on this particular date. Tell him. And this was my voice which I heard, and I thought I must have gone mad and I'm making out by myself. So I took Bible, I said, Lord, confirm me this through your verse. And Lord, I opened the, and this verse came to me. It was from somewhere from Genesis. It came to me, and I opened the Bible. It said second month of 17th, this date. And all of a sudden, it was a reassurance for me. I called my friend and said, yes, you know, this is what God is telling you. Get your visa on this particular date. And after 2 months, praise God, it happened. So, okay, so this was how it started for me. And I believe that God speaks to each one of us. Not only, there is nothing, a degree of holiness for God to communicate. The Bible says there are instances where God has spoken to David. Jesus Christ, when he was tempted, David was asking him questions. And he replied to them. So God talks to everybody. Those who want to listen, God is there who is talking to them. And sister, I want to ask you a second question is, what are the different ways that God can communicate? What you have, apart from the Bible, the Word of God, scriptures, what are the other ways that God communicates?
So amazing things happen when we are in the presence of God. So the second incident that happened is, you know, as I, you know, got more serious with the Word of God and started reading the Word of God, there was another incident where this was a time, around the time when I was pregnant, and I was a little anxious, and that was a period where I wasn't like really reading the Bible every time, but then yeah, on and off, I used to, you know, see if I could, you know, spend some time. And that day, I don't know what happened, the verse that just kept coming back in my mind: be anxious for nothing, but in everything, in prayer and supplication, make your request known to God. And it was just not once, it just kept coming in again and again and again. And it was so amazing because again, you know, God again spoke to me, but it wasn't that I was reading the Bible at that point in time, but He, you know, put that in my mind. And then it also links back to the verse that says in John 14:26, that, you know, the Holy Spirit will bring into remembrance all the things that the Lord has told you. It's so amazing, the Holy Spirit and, you know, the trial, the combination of the God, the Father,
so
the Holy Spirit, just, yeah.
On the mind.
Yes.
That's true. So it happens, yes, which I have also experienced, that God has different ways to speak. And there are times that He communicates through visions. There are times that He communicates through dreams. You might have experienced, you might have seen angels appearing in your dream and showing you something. Often we all mistake it that it might be just a dream. But there are instances where God is talking to us. And this have been my experience several times. There was a small incident which I would like to share. I was in Milan, and it was my first time in Milan, and I was walking from going the mall from a ground floor to the first floor on an escalator, and I was dragging my bag along, and there were these three young ladies who were surrounding me, and I did not understand what they were up to. Since there was still, there was plenty of space, but they were close to me and my bag. But I didn't realize what they were doing. And when I reached the first floor, I started to drag the bag, and I was walking. I walked around 10 steps ahead, and then I could see one girl running back to me. And she keeps two passports. One is mine and my friend's passport, which she has taken from my pocket, and my wallet. And she keeps on my palm, and she keeps running. And I was shocked, and I could hear God telling me inside that, Xavier, without your knowledge, I am the God who protects you without your knowledge. Praise the Lord. And that was an experience what I had. And there are several instances where God speaks to, and He gets involved in smallest of things. Even on the in certain times we want to ask for food. I wanted to eat some Indian food when I was abroad, and I would ask in my heart, God, I know I want to eat this Indian masala food, and instantly I will also have a conversation. I will tell God, it's okay, I know you can't provide now because we are in different places, it's not possible. And I reach home and that particular day is Indian food there. So that's how God works, and He has been providing like that. And God speaks and gets involved in minutest of details. There are several ways. The one is through visions, one is through the dreams, the other is by nature around also, and you can also hear through scriptures, hear the voice which is inside. So several times there is a communication happening, we think we might have gone wrong. We've gone mad that we are talking with ourselves. But it is actually Lord who is speaking to us in our silence. There's a scripture which says, they didn't hear my voice in a mountain, in the wind, but in a silence they hear my voice. So sister, apart this were the two things which I asked you, and thirdly I want to ask, how do we prepare our hearts to hear the voice of God?
Yeah. So like you said, you know, one is through the scriptures of course, and faith comes from hearing and hearing the word of God, and it's so important that we have faith in this awesome God that we have.
Yes.
And we focus our attention, our thoughts, emotions, feeling to this one God, and rejoice in Him always, as I always say. And prepare in terms of, you know, spending time with God, communicating with God. And because God loves to communicate, He wants to constantly talk to us. It's just that we need to be open to hearing to Him, and we can do that when we are in His presence. And presence means, yeah, one is the quiet room, of course, or it could be, you know, when you're walking, you're constantly communicating with God. It could be, you know, in your mind, it could be loud, it could be anyway, but being in His presence and, you know, trusting Him fully and having that faith in Him be one of the things that we see.
So exactly, sister, what you said is to know that God is present, to have that faith to communicate. And belief is one very important thing, believing that God is talking to us. And whenever we ask a question, we must ask it in faith that He is replying to us. Otherwise, there is no use of asking at all. There is one practical solution which I can provide, which we can try, and to know that God is talking to us is simple. My dear friends, just take out a sheet of paper, sit in silence somewhere. It's not the worldly silence which I mean is noise from outside, silence from within. Just calm your mind and just know that God is present, God is loving you. So take out this sheet of paper and read a Bible verse, whichever you like. And after reading, sit in this silent place and ask a question to God. It can be any question that you want to ask. God, how much you love me? God, what should I do? It can be anything. Just ask. Start simple. Ask God something and wait for the answer. Do not move. Just sit there. Close your eyes and wait for the answer. And He speaks from within. And Holy Spirit is in everybody who can confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. And when Holy Spirit is within us, He speaks to us. And when we ask a question, He replies to us back. And that answer you write down for the question. You write down in that piece of paper. You'll be amazed to see that God has answered your prayer. God is speaking to you, and continue that conversation. You have not gone mad. You have not lost your mind. You have become more powerful in God, and your mind has increased to another level. It is united with God who created heaven and earth. So we take this moment now to just close our eyes, and I ask Sister Lucy also to pray for all our viewers, wherever you are, whatever time of realm it may be, morning, afternoon or midnight, right now in the place where you are sitting or standing, Jesus is present with us and with you, and God is talking to you. We pray that your eyes, ears, may open, heart may open, and you may listen to the voice of God. Let us close our eyes for a few minutes. Lord Jesus, we take this moment. Lord, we ask you, we plead you that you may start talking to your son, your sister, and they may start listening to you, Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray very powerfully your hand may touch their ears, and their ears may open to hear your voice from now on. Lord, I pray that you may touch their eyes so they may start seeing your visions. They may start seeing you and your angels, your heaven, and start communicating with you, Lord. Lord, I pray for their hearts may be open, that your words may start overflowing and flowing like a river that comes out from their heart, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Your word is life.
Thank you, Father.
Yes, Father. Your word is everything, and your word is life. And Father, we understand that you are the living water. Yes, Father, and that you will quench our thirst.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Father.
Thank you, Father, for all those who are waiting to hear from you, Lord Jesus. Yes, pour out your Holy Spirit and speak to them through your word, Father. Yes, Father, we understand that the fundamental of everything is your word. Yes, Father, we open everybody's hearts and minds so that they can align to your word and read your word and understand.
From today, Lord, from today.
Yes, Father.
From right now, Lord Jesus, that you are touching their ears, you are touching their heart, Lord Jesus, and you are talking to them, showing, revealing them your plans to them, Lord Jesus. Lord, especially at this moment, those who are watching, who are lost, who are confused what to do in their lives, Lord, you are revealing them new ideas, Lord. Tonight as they sleep or take rest, Lord Jesus, you will reveal to them in their dreams and visions, Lord. And Lord, as they wake up early in the morning, Lord Jesus, you would have placed a new idea in their heart and mind. Lord, all their confusions are washed away. Your words are filling their heart and mind, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus.
The jobs,
thank you, Lord.
People who are seeking for jobs, people who are seeking for a life partner, people who are get closer to you, people who are looking at healing, looking at every aspect of their life, Father Jesus, we give it into your hands, and we know that you are talking to them and you are revealing to them and you are speaking to them, and they have received your word in the name of Jesus, and they understand and that you are directing your path by your word. Yes, Father Jesus, they receive you in the name of Jesus, as you are directed, they know which way to go, which direction to go, and what needs to be done next, because you are speaking to them and they are listening to your voice. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, especially I pray as I see, that you're showing me these old people, Lord, an old lady especially, Lord, that who is on the bed, who is alone, who has nobody to talk to. Lord, if she is watching, it is for her right now that you want to tell her, Lord, that you are with her and you are ready to talk to her at any moment she wants to talk to you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Jesus, hallelujah. Thank you, my dear friends. I'm sure God will touch your lives as you open up your heart to hear His voice. And from now on, God will talk to you and change your life, and your life will never be the same again. Thank you.